This week on Country Music Junkies, I'm pleased to be catching up with Sean from Me and May. Now, Sean, we've chatted before. How have things been going the last little while?
Yeah, we have. I guess it's been a couple of years since we've chatted. A lot's happened since then. We spent around a year ago this time, we acquired a new singer, Caitlin Canning. And then we spent the last year basically kind of in hiding, writing and recording and getting ready for the next wave. And that's what's happening now. And we just released our brand new single, Tell with the Devil.
Now, talk to me a little bit about your time in hiding. We're going to get to this single. I want to hear all about that, of course. What sort of happened?
Well, this is the first time, like when we came back from, we did a big show in California in January. At the beginning of the year, and basically what happened was it was great. It was a huge crowd. The band was happening. Our new singer was just phenomenal. She's just incredible, and we'll get into that later. But when that show was done, I was just hanging out with my manager, and he said, "You know, Sean, all I need now is that I think the band's ready. All I need now is the right songs." I said, "Okay." So you know, I've traditionally always gone out and written with other people. And, you know, and we've hired other producers. He said, "No, I want you to do it this time. I want you to produce and I want you to get more involved." And I mean, I'm always involved in the writing, but, you know, try writing with the band this time and try, and I want you to produce it. And I was like, "Are you sure?" He said, "Yes." I go, "Absolutely sure." You know, I mean, that's what he said. Our manager, Clyde Hill, I have a lot to thank for him because he really pushed me a lot in this past year, and I think it's paid off. So, I mean, I did do some co-writing. I did, in fact, the new single, Tell the Devil, is co-written with an outside writer, a friend and musician friend of ours named Cameron Belter. But the other songs were internal. The other two songs I co-wrote with, we have a collection of four songs that we're only releasing one single right now, but there's more to come. The other two were co-written with myself and Ben Parker, who's our one of the band members, our banjo player, guitar player. And then we brought on a new co-manager who I co-wrote a song with, a guy named Darcy Deutsch. He helped me write one of the songs as well. So yeah, that's been the journey this past year.
Awesome. So talk to me a little bit about To Hell with the Devil. You mentioned it a couple of times. It's your new single. Talk to me a little bit about the story and also the sound of that song.
Well, this is a big one. It's interesting how this song came about because I've been actually, you know, bugging my old friend to write with me, and I kept just, you know, calling him. What are we gonna write? And we were just kind of joking around, throwing song titles around, and Tell the Devil came up. He had mentioned that title. I went, "I love that." So I just hung up on him. I went into the studio. I was actually entering the studio to work on a different song. And I grabbed my guitar and I hummed out this, you know, I must have said Tell the Devil 15 times in the chorus. Tell the Devil, tell the, you know, I didn't have any other words. I just had sort of the melody and the chords. I sent it back to him. He loved it so much. I met with him the next day and the song was written. Between the two of us, we had written the song really quickly. And the story is, I mean, I say it's a pretty common, you know, it's basically about infidelity, straight up, Caitlin and I are telling the story. I'm telling it from the man's point of view. She's telling it from the woman's point of view, and I really think that it's a very relatable, who can't relate to that story, to that cause, you know, to that purpose, you know what I mean? So,
for sure.
Yeah.
Well, that's really cool. Fans, if you want to check out their single, you can head to meandmay.com. Again, that is To Hell with the Devil. Now, Sean, you mentioned that you've got a couple more songs in the works that will be released kind of in the coming months, year. Do you have kind of a timeline for those?
Well, we're just playing it one single at a time for now. We're just kind of... I'm sure something else will come out this year for sure. You know, maybe before the summer, but this one's brand new. So we're going to gauge to see how well this does and then, you know, sort of make decisions from there.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Talk to me a little bit about kind of the band's progression in terms of the live show. So obviously bringing in a new singer, how are the live shows changing and evolving?
Well, it certainly keeps strengthening, and that is, you know, I have to give this credit to, in fact, the fellow who's actually promoting this single right now, Bill Miller from Sharp Nine Music. Him and I are old friends. We kind of started in the music business together, and we've been doing this a long time. And years ago, I've been releasing singles for a while now, and we've tried different things, and I played in different bands. And there was a low point where I was discouraged because this is a tough business.
Yeah.
And he was comforting me as old friends do, and he said, you know, Sean, why don't worry about what you can't control. Just focus on what you can control. And I said, what do you mean? He said, the live show. It's all within your control. And so I just decided to focus on that more than anything else. I stopped worrying about, you know, what single is what, and you know what the people want to hear. I stopped worrying about all that stuff and just say, you know what, I'm gonna make this band such a great live band. I'm gonna make it undeniable. Whether you like this genre or not, you cannot deny that we're not a great live band. And that's really what that's been my main focus over the last 4 or 5 years with this band. And I think it's starting to pay off. I think the member changes and the tweaks and the better songs and all that kind of thing over time. I think it's really come to that point where we're ready for the next level. At least it feels that way.
There you go. Well, again, fans, head to meandmay.com. We'll include a link in the posting of this interview. You can find out more information on Sean, Caitlin, Ben, or Adam, the four members that make up Me and May. Now, Sean, talk to me a little bit about social media and how you guys connect with fans and how you prefer to connect with fans.
Well, my preference is live, of course. I like meeting the fans at the show and hanging out with them before and afterwards. Just the whole experience. And that's why we do what we do. I mean, everything else to me is for the live show. If I had a choice between, you know, somebody said, would you prefer to be in a studio? Would you prefer to be live? I'd rather be live, definitely, because of that interaction.
Sure.
But we do, in today's day and age, you have to connect with your fans on social media. It's the most important outlet at this, you know. So basically, we do encourage people to message us and stay in touch. And we use Instagram and we use Twitter and we, you know, Facebook and all those things. And we try to look at it like we're just one big family. And hopefully it'll be a million people in that family, or millions at some point.
There you go. Well, Sean, thank you so much for taking the time to chat with us today. Again, fans, head to meandmay.com. Find out more. Check out their new single. You can also check them out on their social media. They've got links to those on their website. Download on Apple Music or wherever you get your music, To Hell with the Devil. And, Sean, thank you so much. Looking forward to seeing what's next for you guys.
And thanks again for your ongoing support, Patrice. We really appreciate it.